In the Buddha's time, there was a monk who was known to be disobedient. It was said that he came from a noble birth, and even though he had ordained, he was willful. When other monks would tell him to be clean or organized, he would resist and lash out. We are monks. We must clean up after ourselves and represent ourselves well as we represent the religion. Don't tell me what to do. When he made mistakes and was made aware of them, he would stubbornly fight back. Monk, you must not wear your inner robe too high. When you come out in public, you must wear your outer robe appropriately. Why are you so focused on me? There is no one here to see me other than you. Just mind your own business. Monk, it is not appropriate to hold your bowl so haphazardly. It is better to hold your bowl with two hands. Doing so is safer and the recommended practice that should be followed. Why can't I hold it with one hand? I know what I'm doing, and I haven't dropped it yet. And even if it breaks, I can just get a new one. Monk, when out in public on alms rounds, we should keep our eyes on our bowls and walk mindfully. Do not focus on the food and items we see, lest they lead to stimulating our desires. So I can't even look at anything? You are controlling even what I look at? I'm not taking it. I'm not stealing it. I'm just looking. So what is the harm? Seriously, why is everyone so obsessed with me and what I do? I know what I'm doing. Just leave me alone. Stop telling me this and that. Stop telling me what to do. After many such instances, the obstinate monk was brought before the Buddha. Monk, is it true what they are saying about you? Are you obstinate and disobedient? Yes, sir, I am. Why would you choose to be this way? You are ordained and follow a doctrine that leads to enlightenment. Why would you not listen to the words of people who wish you well? In the past, you also disregarded advice given to you by the wise and were trampled to death by a mad elephant. A long time ago, when Brahmaratta was ruling in Benares, the Bodhisat was born into a wealthy family. The family members spent their life searching for and experiencing pleasure. The Bodhisat observed that the more pleasure people had, the less they saw the reality of the human condition. He observed that when people had power, they lost their sense of humility. He observed that people were desensitized to suffering, loss, and death. The Bodhisat realized that eventually, all beings will die and leave all pleasures and belongings behind. All that we take with us are our qualities. And so, the Bodhisat renounced desire and ordained as an ascetic. Over time, his fame spread, and he became the teacher of 500 hermits. There was a headstrong and unteachable person named Indasamanagotta among his students. Indasamanagotta found a young elephant who had been separated from his herd. Indasamanagotta lured the young elephant back to the hermitage by using sugarcane. All of his fellows said, "Indasamanagotta, an elephant should not be kept as a pet. Let it go." However, Indasamanagotta had become attached to the baby elephant. Having a baby elephant made Indasamanagotta feel special and different from all his fellows. The leader of the hermits summoned Indasamanagotta and said, "Elephants are not meant to be kept as pets. It goes against their nature. To force something to go against its nature is to create suffering for oneself. In addition, do you know how to raise an adult elephant? You must look past your desires and see reality. Elephants have been known to kill even those that own them. You should not keep him." Indasamanagotta said, "I have raised him. I have trained him. He loves me, and I love him. I cannot live without him. I will not let him go." The Bodhisattva then said, "Oh well, you will live to regret your choice." Indasamanagotta continued to raise the elephant, despite his fellow's objections. The elephant grew to an immense size. Not too long after that, the hermits went off on a fruit-gathering mission. Indasamanagotta expected the trip to be short, but the trip ended up lasting many days. The elephant, left alone without enough food, became angry and fell into a frenzy. The elephant thought,
"I will destroy this hut. I'll smash the water jars. I'll tear this place up. If that hermit that left me alone without food comes back, I'll kill him."
In the meantime, while away, Indasamanagotta could not stop thinking of his elephant. Indasamanagotta rushed back with his pack full of fruit and was eager to meet his elephant. However, as soon as the elephant saw Indasamanagotta, the elephant rushed out and pushed his keeper to the ground. The elephant, in a blind rage, then crushed Indasamanagotta's head. Trumpeting madly, the elephant scampered away into the forest. All of the hermits, hearing the commotion, came running to see what was going on. There, they saw Indasamanagotta's dead and crushed body. When the leader of the hermits heard the sad news, he said, "We should have no dealings with the bad. The wise know not to associate with those who do evil. Sooner or later, the evil will do evil. Just like the elephant that killed the hermit, Indasamanagotta. But if you meet a person that you know to hold the same morality, wisdom, and learning as you do, you should choose such a person as your friend. Good friends and blessings go hand in hand. All of you should learn to be docile, humble, and not obstinate. That is the proper training." The hermit leader then performed funeral rites for Indasamanagotta, who served as an example of obstinance for the other hermits. The Buddha then concluded the Jataka by saying, "Indasamanagotta is none other than this obstinate and stubborn monk. And the hermit leader was none other than I."
What did you learn from this story? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads. And consider making a donation to support our Buddhist animation project.